Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and today I'm going to show you how to color grade video footage inside of Premiere Pro. Alright, so the footage that I'm going to use is actually shot on a C200, a Canon C200, and I've shot in a log format. So I'm actually going to show you how to convert that and do all the color grading using the Lumetri panel inside of Premiere. So we're just going to double click here to get our footage in. So my goal with this is to actually use it to submit it to Adobe Stock. So I'm going to do another tutorial where I'm going to show you that whole process of submitting a video to Adobe Stock. But for now, we're going to focus on getting that footage and color grading it. So we've got 4K footage here. And all we need to do to bring it into the timeline here is just drag it into that new icon right there. And if we hit the backslash key, we can pull it out. And there's our footage right there. And in fact, if we go up and look at the sequence settings, under the sequence settings, we can see that there we go. We've got 4K right there, which is Ultra HD. Click OK. Now, if we hit the space bar, we can play this back. And then you can hear we have an audio track. There's actually 4 tracks of audio, as you can see on here. The bottom 2 don't have anything happening, just the track 1 and 2 have the audio you can see there by the waveform. Now we could choose to eliminate that if we held down the Alt key or the Option key. We can click, and I'm going to shift click there to select the 2 tracks that don't have audio, and then we can just right click and choose to just clear. The other thing we could do is just hit the delete key. Now if you want to get rid of the audio entirely, do the same thing. If you click here, it's going to select both the video and the audio, and we can see that's because they're linked. We can choose to unlink, but the fastest way to select them is just to hold down Alt or Option, and you can see we can select those different elements individually. I'm going to show you how to do that color grading right now. So here we go, we've got it, and what we want to do now is we want to open this inside the Lumetri panel. So one of the things we could do is we could just go to the color workspace, and let's just do that right now, and we're just going to reset it. And this will take it right back. This is what it looks like when you first open it. And we can see right there, there's our Lumetri color panels here. Now, one of the things you can do is you can use an input LUT, where you can literally go in here and you can create a LUT. And I'll do that a lot of the time because we're kind of wanting to go to about a Rec 709 if you want to be technical. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to do the whole thing without a LUT. And then we'll actually save our own LUT at the end. And a LUT is just simply a preset. So one of the things we do want to do is we want to look at our scopes. So we're going to click on Lumetri scopes, and you'll notice there's 2 scopes that are showing right now. If we right click, we can see we've got our vector scope here and our parade. A vector scope is what we see here. And we've got another one we can do too, is a hue lightness and saturation. You can see that one there as well, but we're just going to close that one down and we're going to focus with this. This is actually going to show our saturation. As long as we're inside this little space here, the image or the video is not oversaturated. Once we start going outside of here, that's too much saturation and we can be seeing problems. And you can see the different colors here. We've got red, green, blue, etc. So we can see all that magenta. All those little blocks represent those colors. But the one we're really going to focus on here is the RGB parade. So there's our red, green, and our blue. And this is actually what we're seeing in the image. It's kind of representing that. Here's our highlights up at 100. And our shadows down at 0. As you notice, because I shot this in a log format, it's a very flat image, which means that there's lots of dynamic range in there and lots of detail, and we can color grade it now and bring that detail out. So you could just scrub to, you know, a good part of the clip, but because this is pretty much the same, it doesn't really matter where I am. Just make sure that clip is selected. Now, the next thing you want to do is we want to go down here and we're going to go to our color wheels. And you notice we've got shadows, midtones, and highlights. So essentially, if we pull down here, we're going to darken our shadows. And as we do that, watch what's happening right there on our parade. Notice on the parade there, we're now going down and it's moving to the bottom. So this is our shadows. Okay, let's try our highlights. Let's increase this. And it's going to stretch this out. Now, sometimes you'll find in a case like this, there's just not enough latitude from moving these sliders. So let me just double click these sliders to reset them. And we're going to go into the basic correction. And what we want to do is the first thing we want to do is we're just going to push the contrast up a little bit. And as we increase this contrast, notice how it spreads that out a little bit. And in fact, we're going to pull it up a little just to kind of bring it near the middle. So this is a good starting place. All right, so let's go back to our color wheels. Now we can pull our highlights up. Now, if you want to speed this process up, hold down the shift key and you can actually move it much faster. So you can see we can pull this up quite high there without losing anything. Let's do the same thing with the shadows here. And you'll see, like, if it goes over like that, that means it's starting to clip. So we want to kind of pull it up to about there. I know it's kind of like a Pac-Man looking thing. And we might even increase our midtones a little bit. So let's push our midtones up a little bit more to around about the 50. And you can see these here are representing our midtones, and there's about 50 IRE right there. All right, so you can see it's definitely looking a lot more contrast than there was before. Now you can see the color's a little bit skewed here. You'll notice that there's an excess of blue here in the highlights and red there in the shadows. So we could go back to our basic correction here and we could play around with this and pull it down a little bit. And what that's doing, notice how that starts to even up a little bit. That's giving a little bit more even in the colors. So you can see that they match a little bit more. And we can play around with these a little bit more here as well. Like maybe I want to recover a little bit in the highlights, not too much. Open up a little in the shadows. Now we need to bring that back, and we can do that for the blacks and the whites. So let's take that black all the way to zero, which we're seeing here. And let's increase our white. Let's push that white all the way up, stopped about there, and give it a bit more contrast again. And now look at the scopes there. Things are looking a lot better. In fact, the saturation's not bad there. I could just give it a little touch of saturation and take it right up to that edge there if we wanted to go pretty saturated. In fact, let's bring it back a little bit. It's a little much. And so we're looking at that footage now. Let's have a look and see what it's looking like before and after. So what we do is we're just going to go under our effect control, and under effect control, turn lumetri color off. And that's what it looked like before. Very, very flat. And there, now we've got it very high contrast and punchy. So this is kind of like a clean grade. However, you know, I might want to pull the contrast down a little bit because there's a little bit of atmosphere there in the morning. So I'm going to let it go down a bit and get a little bit more foggy. So it just kind of looks a little more style. There we go. So it has a little bit more of a mood there. And I'm even going to pull these blacks down a little bit more. Let's pull those down. And then if we look at our scopes here, we can see we're still within our range. We might be clipping the blacks just a little bit, but that's quite okay. All right, so if we want to preview this, we can just select it and hit the tilde key. And that will go full screen. And now we can see it a lot better. And there's our footage there. You can see that's looking a lot better. Now, there's a lot of different things we could do with this. Let me just hit the tilde key and go back. So another thing we could do is we could stylize this, and we could do this using the creative tab here. So here's our creative tab, and this is where we can do some stylization. So if we want to give a little faded film look, we could do that. See how that kind of just gives it that kind of look. You don't want to sharpen it too much, particularly if you're going to be going and submitting it to stock. And in fact, what we are doing here is when we're doing the saturation, let's go back to the basic correction. We're going to reset that saturation. Keep your eye on there. But what we want to do is do the creative, because when we're in here and we use the vibrance, it actually works better. See how that vibrance is giving a much better result there than using the saturation. In fact, let's pull it back. I was getting a little heavy-handed with that, and see how we're right on the edge there. It's looking good. Now, if you want to do more of that blockbuster look, you know, where we've got the teals in the shadows and the yellows in the highlights, we could do that by clicking here and dragging down towards the teals a little bit. Hit the shift key. It enables us to move this very quickly. I'm just going to give it a light color grade. And let's go in here and then push it up a little bit to warm up those highlights. And now we can see, you know, we've really done quite a lot to this. Let's have a look at it. In fact, why don't we just click and drag this out a little bit and notice how we can just give ourselves a little more space. Let's go into effect control and we can look at it before and after. You can see that we've created a pretty cool look. Now we can save this out as a LUT. Let's go back to the basic correction up here. And we're just going to click up the top here. And we're going to export a cube. So let's do that right now. We're going to export that cube. And we'll create a folder here. We'll call it LUT. And I'm just going to call this one C200 morning. And we're going to hit save. Okay, so this means that if I go to another piece of footage, like let's take this in again and I'll show you. And then we look at it and see how it's just kind of washed out like that. And we want to apply that same look. We just simply go under here, under the LUT. Now I'm doing the input LUT. We could go there or we could go under creative and we're just going to click on browse. And there's that C200 morning that we created. Click open and boom. You can see right there that we can just apply that LUT to all the similar looking footage, and then we don't have to go through the whole process every single time for doing that. So anyway, maybe you want to contribute your videos to Adobe Stock, make some extra income, get them off your hard drive, put them into circulation where people can start using them. Check out that link underneath to become a contributor. I'll also drop a link there where you can get 10 free images from Adobe Stock. So if you like this tutorial, smash that like button into dust. So why don't you drop a comment and let me know what gear you're using. I'd love to know what you're shooting and what you're shooting with. And also, if you're not a subscriber, hit the subscribe button right now. Become part of the Cafe crew. Get a new tutorial every single week. So until next time, I'll see you at the Cafe.